It's hard to feel obsolete. It's hard to feel your skirts are showing. You pull and tug to hide the works, to keep the whole thing going. I think one of my favorite songs on the record is Obsolete. It came from a very true place in my heart of just feeling like, I read a quote on the internet that said, the internet makes everything not enough. So you always feel like you have to be more, and I don't know, you have to sort of market yourself in this strange way. And it reminded me of a story about people just wanting to be seen, wanting to be heard. And I heard this story years ago about a woman in Kansas City who had made a meal for Thanksgiving time for a needy family. And when she got to church, they said, oh, the truck already left. You're going to have to deliver the meal yourself. And she had actually never really been to, you know, this part of Kansas City. And she went driving, and she was on the phone with her friend, and she said, what happens after 42nd Street? Like, I've always been told, don't go past this part of town. And she's like, you know, I'm in it. I'm driving into this part of town. What happens to me now, you know? And so she got her meal out of the car, and she was walking down the street, and she came around a corner and ran into a homeless man. And the food went flying everywhere, and she said, I'm so sorry. I just spilled all this food, and, you know, I just wasn't even looking where I was going. And the man just looked at her, and he said, can you see me? And she said, of course, I ran right into you. I, you know, was picking things up. And he said, are you talking to me? And she stopped, and she said, yes, I'm talking to you. I just ran right into you. And he said, I thought I was invisible. And she was so changed that this man would literally believe that he was invisible because people had been walking by him and never acknowledging him. That story really sticks with me. How many people around us, you know, not to preach, don't text, and, you know, but how many of us are so lost in our sort of invisible empires that we're building online that we don't see people, we don't look at them and say, how are you doing? And I don't know, it feels like a tremendous loss to me that we're failing to connect in these beautiful ways, everyday ways. And so this woman ended up starting one of Kansas City's largest food shelves, and she and her family still work there, and left everything basically that they had. This moment was so life-changing for her. And her testimony really resonates with me and this man who actually believed he was obsolete.
Waiting in.